Guys, so I got my box of live bugs from Rainbow Mealworms, and I'm going to set them all up. But first, I have a really cool surprise. I've been decluttering my house, and now I have enough room for a little bug breeding corner, and I'm so excited to show it to you. Hey, Max, are you excited about the new bug breeding corner? You're going to get more bugs. Are you excited? Yes, you are. Oh my gosh. Okay, let's show it to him. Behold, the bug breeding corner. It used to be a big packing corner where I stored all my regal reptile packing material to ship out backgrounds and things like that, but I have found a new home for that packing material, and now it is home to my bug breeding bins for my worms. The roaches are still in their gorgeous roach cabinet, so right now I have a bunch of mealworm beetles in here, but I'm about to get some wheat brine, and beetles will go up here, baby mealworms will go down here, and this will probably be another set of baby mealworms. There's ventilation, it's just so great, and then these are super worms. And now, because of rainbow mealworms, I have an absolute ton of crickets that I have put with some kale stems in a box with some holes in the lid and some tubes. So those are the crickets. I think I have like 500 medium crickets or whatever. There's a ton of them. It'll be great. So a quick note about kale stems and other stems. We had kale the other night, and instead of throwing the stems away like you normally would, I just saved them so that I could cut them up and use them as moisture food for my insects. That's another way you can feed your lizards or your breeders, or even put them in compost for earthworms. You just save everything you don't use. Now, some things like apple seeds and things like that can be toxic, so you don't want to save those and feed those to your animals. But stuff like kale stems and leftover onion, well, you might not want to feed onion, oranges, the things like that, if you want to save it. The ends of bell peppers, you can chop those up and use those. Not the seeds, but the fleshy part that you might throw away. It's a good way of conserving things and using everything and not wasting anything, so. Back to the bugs. As we stated before, we did get a bunch of crickets and some medium dubia roaches, some mealworms in this bag and superworms in this bag, and the question arises, well, you're breeding dubia roaches, you're breeding mealworms and superworms, why are you continuing to buy them? So, I just want to say again that when you start a breeding colony, you can't immediately use it. Like I mentioned in another breeding video, you would want to wait an entire breeding cycle, which is how long it takes for a egg to become a baby and grow to adulthood and become a breeder. So for dubia roaches, that is 6 months. So if you are starting a brand new dubia roach colony, and you put your colony together and it's perfect, you still want to wait 6 whole months before you can use that colony. And in that time, you're still going to want to buy insects for your animals to eat. And that is because you want to make sure that you have a stable population in your breeding colony. Because if you start using the babies immediately, and you're going to want to, believe me, there won't be any new breeders, and your first group of breeders will die off really quickly, you know, eventually, and then you won't have any more breeders to continue with your colony, and its population will dwindle as you feed them off. So, wait an entire breeding cycle. And that's what we're doing now. So these are food for the lizards and stuff. I already have a good chunk of beetles and stuff to breed me worms and things like that. So let's put the roaches up. So a really quick note here. I actually took the second roach bin, and instead of using it as a baby bin, I put 5 females and 2 males in it. And I'm going to leave them alone. I'm going to feed them and not touch any of their offspring, pretty much starting a new colony, because this one is slowly dwindling. I did not follow my advice I just gave y'all earlier about waiting an entire breeding cycle. So we're going to see what happens with this one, especially since I'm planning on making my reptile collection a little bit bigger, and I want to make sure I have enough food for all these lizards. This is the bin I use to feed my animals with. So we're going to add all the new medium roaches to this container. This is so much easier than the crickets. Like, as soon as I did that, the crickets just exploded. We're just going to let these guys all fall out. Make sure there's none left in the cup. There you guys go. Oh, look at all these cool medium roaches. They're gorgeous. See how many of them live to maturity. That'd be kind of cool. You can hang out right there, and you guys can hang out over there. Ta-da! There's even food in there for y'all. Have a good life! Next, we're going to go with the superworms, and I brought out a big bin from the bottom of the drawer to put them in. Just kidding, we are going to open the bag. The fun part about superworms is they always climb up, so check them out. They're all trying to escape. Oh my goodness. Wow, this is scary. I'm about to put some oatmeal. I have some leftover oatmeal I'm going to put in there for them. Didn't have as much oatmeal as I thought, so I added some paper, and then I added some kale pieces so they can eat and have enough moisture. So there you go. This will probably make my job harder, but we are going to add the mealworms to this already established mealworm tub. Mealworms. The mealworms are trying to figure out the crossword puzzle. They're all going to go burrow, so I will give them some food too. And there we go. All the bugs are put away and happy. That took a long time. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please like and subscribe. And if you have any questions, leave them in the comment section. I love to answer questions about anything. Don't worry about how silly it sounds. And hopefully, I can help you out. If you guys have any suggestions or ideas, please leave those in the comments too. I love to learn. And I will see you guys again in the next video.